See, a lot of people say, yeah, they want high growth. They want to grow and grow their companies. But I'd argue they're only really interested in achieving that. They're not committed. The challenge is a lot of people and a lot of companies are setting their vision based on current reality, based in terms of where they are now. Take it in terms of potentially where you actually want to be, go and set that vision. If you know how to go and get your vision, I would argue you haven't set it hard enough.
My message to you is that you cannot separate high growth businesses and high growth economy. And if we're going to generate high growth in our local economy, there needs to be some major change.
Growth Accelerator is a government-backed scheme that is delivered by private sector growth experts, and it's very much focused on providing tailored and bespoke advice to your business.
So Growth Accelerator businesses are growing 4 times faster. Not one, not two, 4 times faster than the average SME in the UK economy. Now, I think that's pretty amazing.
So the key to a leader is to break down impossible goals, or seemingly impossible goals, and turn them into manageable objectives. Greatness is a matter of conscious choice. Are you prepared to fail? Are you prepared to try? But are you prepared to have a go? So by breaking down and delivering a roadmap of an impossible goal, suddenly life becomes a little bit more realistic.
Control of two things. One is your emotions. Control of your emotions internally, fear, anxiety, all that stuff inside. But secondly, controlling how you respond to everything that hits you on a daily basis. You know how we have like 20 things that are negative that hit you every day? It's how you respond to those that's really key. So you control that and you stay in control all the time.
I've built my whole career on being given an idea, chopping it in half, turning it upside down, questioning it, turning it inside out, unpacking it, being told I'm crackers, and then putting it together into something that does work.
Well, in the Midlands, all the movers and shakers come to this event, and many people know that if you want to move to the next level, you need to hang out with people who are at the next level.
Well, everything I've seen so far, that the nuggets, the golden nuggets of information, some things you know, but it's just getting it back again, and when you actually get it back, I must use that again.
It's just something, some really good insights into people's, the way they've run their businesses or run their lives, and it just gives you a real idea about things you can do that you didn't think you could do before.
I think it's really valuable to be in an environment where people want to move forward and want to network and there's a positive attitude.
I'd recommend it as the best SME event certly in Nottingham, possibly in the Midlands, to attend.
We're looking to actually sort of build an international community of high growth companies and really go and take the summit together with the high growth network to a totally new level.
We went to Australia in 1998 and lost 76-0. 5 years later, 75% of those lads returned to win a World Cup in their Olympic stadium. We lost the Grand Slam in 1999, Scott Gibbs 2000, Duncan Hodge 2001, Keith Wood 2002, Serge Betson, with monotonous regularity. And yet we found a way to understand what happened, what went wrong, and continually stayed on that upward trajectory.